Jesus, the Lamb of God, covers all my sin. Jesus, the Lamb of God, I will walk with Him. Jesus, the Lamb of God, covers all my sin. Jesus, the Lamb of God, I will walk with Him.
He says, come to the promised land, live every day with me. He says, come to the promised land, there you will be free. He says, come to the promised land, live every day with me. He says, come to the promised land, there you will be free.
Jesus, the Lamb of God, covers all my sin. Jesus, the Lamb of God, I will walk with Him.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together, with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, their sins are forgiven. If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven." Now Thomas, also known as Didymus, one of the 12, was not with the disciples when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the nail marks in his hands, and put my finger where the nails were, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. Though the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here. See my hands. Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." Thomas said to him, "My Lord and my God." Then Jesus told him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Jesus performed many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in His name.
But after Jesus rose from the dead, he came and visited his disciples. Well, he spent a lot of time on earth with his disciples. If you call 40 days a lot of time. He spent time on earth with his disciples after he came back from the dead. Now, and he had very, very first risen. The disciples didn't know yet what was going on. And they were still scared. They were scared because they thought Jesus was still dead. They were scared because the Jews, the people who were in the temples and the bad guys, had killed Jesus. And they were worried, what if these bad people come for us too? What if they try to arrest us and kill us? So they were hiding. The disciples were all gathered in a room together with the doors locked because they were scared. They were afraid. They were worried, and they didn't know what was going to happen to them. And then, through these locked doors, appeared Jesus. Jesus came and said, look, here I am. I'm alive. You don't need to fear anymore. You don't need to worry. Here's my hands and my side. It's really me, but I'm alive. And because I'm alive, you have hope. And Jesus breathed on them. He breathed on them the Holy Spirit. And with that, he gave them his peace. He said, I'm giving you peace. Instead of fear, have peace. Instead of worry, have hope. Be comforted. I am giving you forgiveness. You've been forgiven of your sins. And now you can go pass that on and forgive others when they do things to you. Jesus wanted them to know, don't be afraid. I'm here. I'm with you. I have died and come back to life. I have conquered death, the biggest fear, the biggest enemy. That's all over. And we have that hope too, because Jesus is still alive today. He might not be walking around on earth, but he's still present with us. And that presence provides peace. We don't have to carry those fears as burdens. We can give them to God. We can give them to Jesus and ask for his peace, and he will replace our fears. Sometimes that seems easier said than done. It's kind of like when you turn on a light in the middle of a dark room. The light cancels out all that darkness, and you're not afraid of the dark anymore. Well, we can give our fears to Jesus. We can know that his peace will surround us and comfort us, that his peace is possible, his hope is possible. All we have to do is ask. Give your burdens, give your fears, give your worries to God. He's big enough to carry them. And his peace will feel like a nice squishy pillow in place of those.
Here.